India is with Mr. Simarpreet Singh of Hartek Group. I'm going to today talk to him about something that I don't get the opportunity to talk to startups about. Mr. Singh, hi, lovely having you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
You're in the solar space. I know very few startups who are taking the agenda of taking India's need forward.
Correct.
For power. I want to know some very quick things from you. But first, I hear that your family business was actually in the solar space, and you know, you've innovated it to fine-tune it to what is required today. Can you tell me what you're doing with your baby, Hartek Group?
Okay, so Hartek Group was started by my father way back in 1991. We started off with an electrical trading business way back about 28 years back. And now the Hartek Group is into setting up power infrastructure across the country, power and renewable infrastructure. So we set up these electrical substations, transmission lines, we set up solar projects, and we also manufacture these electrical panels. I joined the organization about 8 years back. And the very first venture that I started was by the name of Hartek India. Hartek India was a backward integration of what we did. So it used to manufacture electrical switchboard panels, which the whole purpose was to solve this problem of, you know, this transmission distribution losses. So that was the product that we manufacture. In fact, every commercial building, every industrial building requires our panels. So we supply those to across the country. The second venture was a venture that was, I was inspired by Mr. APJ Abdul Kalam Saab, who's been, I think, the country's mentor, the country's inspiration. And if you see that in India, out of 1 billion people, still 300 million people are not connected to the grid, right? In globally, out of 7 billion people, 1 billion people do not have electricity. How do you solve this problem? So that was the formation of Hartek Solar, which is one of India's leading rooftop solar companies. So we set up these rooftop solar projects across the country. And so that's been, a very fulfilling journey that, that has been there. And, the whole purpose, I was speaking in the earlier session, is that it is important, why do you do what you do? It's not important what you do. It's important, why do you do it? And we've set up these lot of projects, and someone calling up and say that it has reduced our electricity bill and the carbon footprint really inspires me to work even harder for both the ventures. And so that's the whole journey.
Tell me, how are you competing competition? We know SoftBank is pumping money for solar panels. We know that there is a lot of push by the government.
Correct.
And the government is in the requirement of more innovative solar products.
Correct. Correct.
And one more important thing that I hear is that you're supplying these panels to the IITs, which is, I think, the tip of the iceberg. It will give you that kind of publicity, and it can definitely help your business as well as take the agenda of putting solar panels all across. Tell me, how are you innovating your product? How are you beating competition? How do you call yourself different, the USP of your brand?
Correct. I'll just like to clarify two points. One is that, so once you say SoftBank is pumping money, that is actually good for us. So we are not into manufacturing of solar panels. We actually set up the entire infrastructure. So that is known as an EPC, which is engineering, procurement, construction. I believe that companies like EPC companies should all be there so that the entire solution has to be given to the end consumer, right? The consumer at the end of the day doesn't bother about whether you're installing an X solar panel. It wants to get in touch with a company that provides complete 360-degree services. So we basically provide that.
That's the USP.
Yeah, that's the USP. The second point which you asked about, how do you tackle competition and places like IIT Delhi and all these things. Our focus has always been to be involved in projects which are of national interest, right? We've been involved in this project, with one of our customers. Even today in Chandigarh, and Chandigarh's first mandir was done by us, which was inaugurated by the Member of Parliament, Kiran Kher, here. Now, I'll take a case study of the mandir. What a mandir does, it's a community place, right? Where community people come and, takes blessings of the Almighty. Our purpose of doing that project there, it did make commercial sense to us. But why I wanted to do that project is that, वहाँ पे हजारों लाखों लोग आते हैं And once they get inspired, okay, it makes commercial sense, and it is a service to the community at the end of the day, right? Aap apna carbon footprint kam kar rahe ho, aap electricity free kar rahe ho. So the USP is that I'm very particular on picking up these projects. Even the first commercial building of Chandigarh was done by us. So across India, I think apart from quality and providing complete 360D services, another USP which, you know, I mentioned was picking up projects of national interest, which creates a sense of community building, creates a sense of nation building. So that's the whole focus.
And what do you think about our young entrepreneurs who are involved in the process? We're seeing a lot of growth in matured ecosystem.
Correct.
And Chandigarh, of course, is a breeding ground for that.
Correct.
What is your view on the developing ecosystem, specifically in solar? You know, where do you think we stand 5 years from now, or maybe 10 years from now? I say 5 years because things change in the next 5 months, you just don't know.
Correct. You know, just to answer this, in 2011, when the first national solar mission was launched, right, in that year, we had a target of 20 gigawatt, which was further revised to 100 gigawatt of solar installations, right? And we have already crossed the 20 gigawatt about a year back. So, you know, just to tell you the sense of nation building that's already been there in the country, that's amazing. My message to entrepreneurs at large is, I think, focus on the larger vision. You know, I keep telling this to a lot of, you know, startups and my entire team, that profit and reward is a byproduct of the problem that you solve. So we forget the problem that we're solving. So at Hartek, if we are focused on solving this problem that a billion people should get connected to the grid and should have clean and sustainable power, that is a problem that we're solving. Now, the byproduct would be a reward or a recognition or a profit, right? So I think my message to all entrepreneurs would be that rather than focus more on the valuation and the great terms, I think let's focus on the larger vision, that why they were there in the first place of building that. So I think at Hartek, our focus is that. And I think we will continue to build a sustainable and a better nation for our future generations in the years to come.
How the hand-holding of the government is happening in this case? Do you see significant hand-holding? Do you see a push that is helping besides Correct. The press conference that we have? Do you see on-ground reality with respect to putting the solar agenda up on the map of the country?
Absolutely, ma'am. So if you see the India's power generation, we are at 350 gigawatt total, combining of thermal, hydro, solar. And now solar and renewable energy is about 28-30%. And the last 5-6 years, I think the government has marketed this sector wonderfully. And now it is up to us, right? We start, you know, I strongly believe that it is up to people like us, people, the entire community, to come together and identify ki this is the need of the hour, right? Government is a facilitator at the end of the day, right? And I believe that if consumers focus that, okay, I have to put solar panels on my roof and I want to, you know, contribute towards reducing the carbon footprint, I think nothing can stop us. And we are, you know, people call us as a country of a billion problems. I see India as a country of a billion opportunities.